Whether you're used to cruising cats or coming to them for the first time, the bottom line is that they're very different to monohulls. But how? Why does it matter? We've come to Tortola in the British Virgin Islands, one of the centres for catamaran cruising, where we've been lent a Moorings 4800, and we're joined by renowned multi-hull designer Nigel Irons. First of our new series on multi-hulls, we take a look at what the issues are when it comes to handling a cruising cat and how to get away with the minimum of fuss. Well, Nigel, we're on board the boat and I have to say it's quite an intimidating sight. It's a big wide boat, we're high up and the fairway looks very narrow out there. I mean, yeah. How do we get out?
I know it is a bit daunting, but actually it's probably not quite as bad as it looks. One of the things we have on a catamaran, which is really useful, is that the engines, obviously there are two of them and they're well spread, so that you can turn the boat around from 360 degrees without it going anywhere. And that's really handy when we're trying to do a slow manoeuvre out of here, because obviously rudders only work when the boat's moving forward fast, or faster than that.
And what about the windage? I mean, big topsides we've got here, is that going to be a factor?
Probably. I don't know to the extent on this boat that there'll be a problem. We'll be finding that out later on in the day because it's my first time on this boat, but certainly it's an issue, yeah.
Well, let's go and give it a go.
Let's do that.
So, here you go. You're off. First, resist the temptation to use the wheel. Using the engines will give you plenty of steerage while keeping things simple. Here, Nigel uses reverse thrust on the port engine to turn the boat. Once you're through the turn and have gathered speed, you can steer using the helm. Simple. You look like a pro. But what if your trip starts by having to spring off the dock in a breeze?
So we've just got to make a game plan for pulling away from this dock now. And we've got to prepare things a little bit. The first thing is we're going to need a fender right forward on the bow. Because as the stern comes away, the bow is going to go in. We don't want to damage the bow. And then we're going to double up the lines, both the spring line and the breast line, so that we can all be aboard. Then we will pull through, cast off the breast line. Then we'll be just hanging on that one diagonal spring. I shall drive her forward a bit and get the stern off, and then I'll drive right astern. That's the spring will go slack, and we can just pull the end through. So in preparation, we just have to double up the lines first. That's so much prettier because it's pulling horizontally now, which is what it's supposed to be. And if you can just take the end of that back up to the cleat there. Again, I'll make it so the rope isn't pulling too hard at that time. That's lovely, yeah. You could. So I think the first line to let go is the bow line, really. That shouldn't change much. And then when you're ready, Jonathan, if you let that go and pull it all back on board. Now we're springing back on that. And now you can pull all that in. So that seemed to work okay. You have to make quite bold moves when there's strong wind like that, because there's a moment when we haven't got anything attached. And that seemed to come away nicely without taking up too much room or getting near that mole there.